elasticity of demand. Kinds of elasticity. Elasticity of demand measures the sensitiveness of a change in quantity demanded of a commodity due to a given change in its price. Whenever price changes, quantity demanded also changes. The concept of elasticity of demand attempts to assign a numerical value to the sensitiveness and identify five types of elasticity of demand. For the time being, you need not bother about the mechanism by which the numerical value is arrived at. You just follow the discussion and try to understand the five types of elasticities. If the elasticity value is equal to infinity, the demand is perfectly elastic. We have perfectly elastic demand. There is perfectly inelastic demand when the elasticity value is equal to zero. These are the two extreme cases. In between these two, we have relatively elastic demand. In this case, elasticity value is greater than 1. Unitary elastic demand is identified with the elasticity value equal to 1. When the value of elasticity is less than 1, the demand becomes relatively inelastic. This is popularly known as relatively inelastic demand. Thus, we have five types of elasticity of demand. Next, we shall try to define the different kinds of elasticities. In doing so, I will compare percentage change in quantity demanded with percentage change in price. Again, for the time being, you need not bother about the calculation of percentage change. It will be discussed under the methods of measuring elasticity of demand. You just try to understand the definitions. Perfectly elastic demand. Infinitesimal fall in price causes quantity demanded to increase infinitely. Look at the demand curve. It is flat, horizontal, and parallel to the x-axis. It means the fall in price is insignificant, but innumerable quantity of good is demanded. We define perfectly elastic demand as a situation in which infinite quantity is demanded at the existing price. Relatively elastic demand. The demand curve is relatively flat. The price falls from P2 to P1. Quantity demanded expands from M1 to M2. Increase in quantity demanded is greater than fall in price. In defining elasticity of demand, we never take into account the absolute change in quantity and price. Instead, we use only the percentage change. Demand is relatively elastic when the percentage change in quantity is larger than the percentage change in price. In the graph, the price falls by 20%, quantity demanded increases by 80%. Hence, the demand is relatively elastic. Unitary elastic demand. Unitary elastic demand refers to a percentage change in price brings out exactly an equal percentage change in quantity demanded. The demand curve is non-linear. The shape of the curve is known as rectangular hyperbola. When the price falls from P2 to P1, the fall in price is 30%. Due to this, quantity demanded increases by 30%. Quantity moves up from M1 to M2. Relatively, inelastic demand refers to the percentage change in quantity demanded is less than the percentage change in price. The demand curve is relatively steep. When the price moves down from P2 to P1, the percentage change in price is 50%. Because of this, quantity demanded increases from M1 to M2. It accounts for only 20% change in quantity. Perfectly inelastic demand refers to no change in quantity demanded for any change in price. Look at the demand curve. It is a vertical straight line and parallel to y-axis. Even though price falls from P2 to P1, the quantity demanded remains unchanged at M. Demand is totally unresponsive. We have learned the 5 kinds of elasticity of demand. In the next lesson, we shall learn how to measure price elasticity.